In the age of internet video, having a good thumbnail for your project is more important now than ever. A video thumbnail is like a book cover and can be the difference between people clicking on your video or just scrolling by. The good news is, you can create a great eye-catching thumbnail without having to leave Final Cut Pro. Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge and welcome back to another Final Cut Pro tutorial. If, like me, your final destination for your project is the internet, having a great, eye-catching thumbnail that pops is very important. In this video, I'll show you how you can create a great-looking thumbnail right in Final Cut Pro, using the thumbnail used in my previous video as an example. Just a quick reminder, if you enjoy this, or any other one of my videos, please hit the subscribe button below. To make a thumbnail for your video, first, create a new project in the same event your video is in. From the menu bar, select File, New, and Project, or use the keyboard shortcut Command N. Next, give your project a name and select a video format. I would recommend using the same format for your thumbnail as your project. If your project is HD, use the 1080p format, or if your project is 4K, I'd recommend using the 4K format for your thumbnail project. Since your final product will be a still image, the video frame rate and the audio options don't really matter here. Next, for your main thumbnail image, you have a couple options. Option 1 is using a screenshot from one of your video clips. Skim over one of your browser clips, and with a skimmer over the frame you want to use, press Option F on your keyboard. A 4-second freeze frame is added as a connected clip to your timeline. I'll press Command Z to undo that. Option 2, and the preferred option if available, is using a high-quality still image. The higher resolution of the still image will give you more flexibility when editing your thumbnail. Select your still image in the browser, and press E on your keyboard to add it to your timeline. The clip duration isn't important in this case, but pressing Shift-Z will zoom in on your clip to fill a timeline and give you more space to work with. Also, if your image is a different aspect ratio than your project, crop in on the image to eliminate the black bars. I'm not going to get too deep into this, but research shows that depending on your video subject, having a person in your thumbnail may get you more clicks. In my example, I want my subject to stand out a bit, so I'll desaturate the background while bumping up the saturation on my subject. First, duplicate your clip by holding down the Option key and dragging up. Next, from the Effects browser, add a draw mask to your top clip. Add control points in the viewer to outline your subject. You can zoom in the viewer for more precision. Next, with your top clip selected, in the inspector, select the color inspector, and in the saturation tab, drag up the global puck to give your subject a little bit more color. Next, select your bottom clip and bring down the global puck to desaturate your background. Another common practice used by some bigger YouTubers to make something pop in their thumbnail is adding a border around it. Since our subject in the top clip is isolated, this will be nice and easy using a downloaded plugin. The one I use is BrettFX Outliner and can be downloaded from brettfx.com. Open the effects browser and drag and drop the effect over your clip. There's a number of parameters in the inspector that can be adjusted, depending on your image. For my example, the default presets work perfect. For our next step, since this is a Final Cut Pro tutorial, let's add the Final Cut Pro icon between our subject and the background. First, download the icon with a transparent background. Next, click and drag the image from the browser and drop it between the two clips in the timeline. Use the Transform tool to resize the image, and in the inspector, bring down the opacity slider to make it partially transparent. We can also add some text to our image by adding a title. To add a basic title, open the Titles and Generators sidebar and type in Basic in the search box. Select Basic Title, and with your playhead at the start of your project, press Q to connect it to your timeline. Now, over in the inspector, select the Text Inspector tab and enter in your text. This is where you can also adjust the font, size, color, and many other parameters of your text. You can also reposition, resize, and even rotate your text here. Here's a bonus tip if you're making a thumbnail for YouTube. Adding a bright border around your image will make your thumbnail appear highlighted. To add a border to your image, first press Command A to select all your clips, and Option G to combine all your clips into one compound clip. Next, in the effects browser, type in Simple Border into the search box. Drag and drop it over your clip, adjust the width, and change it to a nice, bright color. And there you have it, a nice, bright thumbnail image to use when uploading your video. To export this image, simply place your playhead anywhere over your clip, hit the Share button, and choose Save Current Frame. If you don't see a Save Current Frame preset, you can add it by clicking Add Destination. Select your file type, hit Next, and choose your destination for your image. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and this gives you some ideas on how to create an eye-catching thumbnail for your next video. As always, if you have any questions, ask in the comments below, and either me or someone else who knows the answer can help you out. And if you haven't yet, check out the rest of my channel for more Final Cut Pro tutorials. New videos release weekly, so hit the subscribe button so you don't miss them. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you back next week.